now that I've completely set up and pushed all I needed on the Jenkins server, I just have one thing to do. It's to configure the freestyle project in Jenkins and then run the test. So let's go back to Jenkins. So let's connect. And so what I'll be doing here is a new job, a freestyle job, and running a NeoLoad test. So I click here on new item. I'll call that NeoLoad test, for instance, and do a freestyle project. Then click on OK to create a new job. And now I'll fill in all the details to run the test. So what I have here is I'm not going to need source code management. I'm just going to need a very simple build step here, which is going to be execute a NeoLoad scenario. And I'll be filling in here all the fields. So here I need to point to the place where NeoLoad is installed. So on my server, it's in here, but it can be pretty much anywhere depending on where you installed it. And I need to point to the NeoLoad executable, which is always called NeoLoad CMD. And then I'm going to point to my local project. So you've seen I've pushed my project with SCP. So here, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be pointing to my Jenkins home directory, which is where I put it, in var lib Jenkins, like this. And it's in the NeoLoad projects folder. It's called sample project, so like this. And I need to point to the NLP file, and that's it. File doesn't exist. We'll see later if that's good. And then I need to now point to the scenario name, which is the one we saw earlier, which was one impact local. I'm going to keep this by default. I'm going to keep everything default for the license. I'll be using the existing one, which is where I placed it, the license.lib file. I'll have those default trend graphs, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add one just to point to a graph that exists in the project. So here I'm going to point to, it's going to be called mobile submission, and I'm going to point, you can see here the model, so name of the user path, actions block, and name of the transaction. So here I'm going to point to the script, which is my iPhone user underscore create underscore report actions block, and the transaction is submit report, and I'm going to want to have the average. And now I'm going to add some post-build actions to be able to archive all the results of the test. So first I'm going to archive the artifacts. So it's going to be NeoLoad report / and all the files. We can correct that to smaller pictures. I'm going to add another one, which is publishing the JNH results. So here, same thing, it's NeoLoad report. And I'm going to just here say JUnit sar.xml to archive the test report for JUnit. And I'm going to add, in case the trends are not good, I'm going to add this action here. And also what I want to do, because sometimes I won't have results at the end, so like if the test didn't run or whatever, I don't want to fail the build, so I'll just do this to not fail it, and here tick this box to not fail when I have empty test results. And here I'm going to save that. And that's it. Now I've created my freestyle job. And all I need to do is click on build now to run my test. So I can see here a build has started. I can go here into the console and see what's happening. So I can see here my command line has started to run. My project was found in here, sampleproject.nlp. I'm launching a scenario, so this means the command line has found the project and has initialized the project. So I'm going to see here very soon my test running. And here it is now. The different steps have started. My test is running, and I'm going to see results at the end. So you can see here, I've managed to run a test from NeoLoad. What I need to do is wait for the test to end to then retrieve the project with the results to be able to analyze it. We'll see in other videos how to look at tests while they're running. So we can do that, for instance, with NeoLoad Web. When you combine NeoLoad Jenkins and NeoLoad Web, you'll be able to see those kind of things. Also, we'll see in other videos how to use the Team server to be able to have more than 3 licenses to run tests.